I don't know who he is behind that mask of his, but I do know when we need him. And we need him now.
Yes, Commissioner.
Great Scott!
You mean, after all this time, some people still need help plastidipping the cowl?
I'll take care of it right away. It's dark as pitch. To the bat hole.
All right, so today we're gonna show you how to properly plastidip a really nice latex cowl. Now this cowl, there's nothing wrong with it. I've worked on it. I'm gonna show you a few things how to make it just perfect before we get started with the plastidipping. I've done other videos like this, but I'm gonna do it again because I wanna have a little bit better clarity, and I've learned things through the years. It's been like 25 after all, you know? So let's see what I can transfer on. All right, so one of the first things I like to be able to do is, I like to take some type of a little implement like this, or a little Bondo spreader or something like that. Some material. You can use caulk, you can use latex, you can use Plastidip, you can use lots of different things. If you don't want to have any depressions, just fill them in. Then take a little bit of mineral spirits or your finger or a Q-tip and just wipe them off and make sure that the surface is smooth.
Use a Dremel with one of these felt bits.
And take down anything that might have be a raised area. Then take a little bit of mineral spirits, just a little bit on this rag, get it on there, go to a drier section once you get it soaked in, and use the rag itself to buff that down. Now that'll eat away at the latex and it'll make it smooth. That thing is gone. So once you've gone around your whole cowl and you think it's as good as you need it to be, you've filled in all the depressions and you've burned down anything like that, you're ready to plastidip. The greatest stuff for latex, it loves it, if you know how to do it properly. Lightness is key. Also, how to get it to be smooth is also key, unfortunately. Around the turn of the century, you didn't have this type of a top on the Plastidip. You had a top more similar to this. Came out in a much better mist, and you didn't really have to smooth that out. It just went on smooth. But you gotta remember, this stuff's really made for tool handles. That's what they think it's for. And they must have just decided, well, this is better, all right? I don't think it's good, but I'm gonna show you how to get around that defect. So when you spray with it now, you're gonna get a lot less smoothness. We're gonna make up for that with the technique. So when it goes on, look at that. That's no good. Look at that. That's crazy, right? Well, believe it or not, this will actually dry pretty smooth. But what I like to do is I like to work it in. Now I've shown this technique with other cowls, like my DOJ, or a cowl that has a lot of details on it. Take a regular cheap chip brush like this. It'll work in that into the detail if you have a cowl that has details on it. And it'll work with a smooth cowl too. And I'll tell you why. We're getting pretty well right now. It's pretty smooth right now. And I haven't even done the final step. I'll show you that in a minute. Of course, these do have bristles that get in your way. That's just one of the things you're gonna have to do. You can use a better brush if you want to, but you're gonna waste the brush, so it's a shame to use a more expensive brush. So I'm gonna do that to every little section, make sure it's on there really good. I like to take the cowl and hold it like this upside down to get in those eyes underneath, the nose underneath, the chin underneath. I like to do that because otherwise they're just not gonna get it as well if you just spray and you don't pay attention to those areas. So I force that in there. And I like to treat one area at a time. I don't want to get too far ahead of myself. Even if I get too far ahead of myself, it's very forgiving if you know how to work with it. As long as my brush is wet, the thinner on the brush is going to thin any other part of the Plastidip that I touch. And I get a nice, smooth finish. You don't want to put more Plastidip than you need to. Because if you put too much Plastidip, what happens is this doesn't stretch as much. The latex stretches a lot more than this. So if you put too much on, and you stretch your cowl, it's gonna want to delaminate. This is a regular returns cowl, and I think I'm gonna do a video on this for you. Before I do any more work with the Plastidip, I wanna show you how to stretch this real quick. Put it on. This is a real returns cowl. Consider it was made for Keaton. I think I did okay to get it to where it works for somebody my size. Now I also have one of these that I make that's made for an extra, extra large. I want to make sure that I like the way it fits before I do any more Plastidip, because the latex is very flexible and the Plastidip is less flexible. All right, the face is fitting good. I'm feeling a little bit right here on my throat. So I'm gonna take this off and I'm gonna put my foot in it on the ground and I'm gonna pull. As hard as I can. So basically what I did on the ground down there was I put my foot like this and I pulled up this as hard as I could. And then I put my foot on the side and I pulled that as far as I could. I'm gonna put it back on and the neck should feel better. Oh, it goes on easier too. My nose is feeling it down here just a little bit. I could cut away some more of this down on the bottom of the nose, but I like to keep it there because it keeps the nose more in shape. There we go. Okay, the top of my eyes, I'm feeling it just a little bit. Now I can go in there and I could cut the interior down and I could cut it so that less eye insert goes into my eyes, but I don't want to. I just want it to fit better. All right, that feels good. It's not pushing on my neck. Still touching the bottom of my chin a little bit. Let me look in the mirror here and see what I got. Okay, it's looking pretty good. This is pretty much the way I want it to be. So let me just show you again what other options I could have had. I could have taken the cowl, taken the inside of the eyes, and trimmed these down more with a small pair of scissors like this. And it wouldn't have touched my eye area as badly. That's one of the options I could have gone with. But I wanted to have that nice deep eye in there. What I did instead was stretch it out away from my face. And that way, when you're looking at it, you see, well, look at how deep that is. It's really deep. You know, when somebody sees you from the side, you go, whoa, that's cool. It goes all the way back to his eye socket. You know, that's pretty cool. Instead of this flimsy little appearance of like a cheap mask, this has got some, you know, oomph to it. You know, the bottom scallops. Now, they're hollow currently. Now, I can fill these in with latex, but I don't really most of the time because if I take some of that Velcro and I glue it down in there to Velcro to a cape, well, that Velcro needs this lip to kind of hide down underneath. And so I like that little lip there. Now, if you don't want that, this could be filled in with latex and made solid and really heavy. But there's really no point because no one sees it. Nobody sees it from this side. So I usually just leave those like that. Now that we know that the cowl is fitting properly, we're going to get back to finishing Plastidipping it. It's a little section at a time, like I said. One of the reasons that I like this brush technique is that we're ensuring that we're mopping off the excess as we go along, and we're just having a really light Plastidip coating over top of it all, which is good because that light coating is still going to flex. Very similarly to the way the latex flexes. If you go on real thick, you can cause yourself problems. A lot of times when people are doing body armor and things like that that move, if they coat it too thickly, and any part that moves, like the legs or the arms, over time, you're gonna see a separation and the Plastidip's gonna start to crack prior to the latex. And when that creates hard parts and soft parts, it can actually aid the latex in becoming less strong than it could be too, because the hard is pulling differently than the soft and it's creating all kinds of little pockets in there. And that's just not a good idea. So what I would recommend is do what I'm doing here, no matter what you're doing with Plastidip. Put on just the right amount. Get it all nice and smooth. And all you're really doing is a protective finish that's sealing in the latex. Depending on your environment and other circumstances, like latex could get a little chalky. It is a natural substance. And you don't want that. You want to seal that in. Doesn't matter what happens on the other side, but you want to seal it in. You want your outside to look good. You want it to look black. One time I went to a convention, way, way early on, and I went with just latex, not a coated cowl. And the photography came back, even though it looked black to the naked eye, the photography all came back with all the flashes reflecting off that. And it looked gray. So I always recommend, people say, do I have to Plastidip my cowl? No, you don't have to. But the Plastidip will help with the photography process to make it look more in the photos the way it does in real life, the way you think it should look. So what I like to do is Plastidip my piece because I'm gonna get its uniform black finish. And it's gonna look good in the photographs and it's gonna look good in real life. You shake this really, really, really well. And you get lucky and you get a good tip and you make sure it's clean. Once you've got a really smooth finish, for your second coat, a lot of times you can go over it like that. If you like what you see and you don't have any great big noogies, you probably get a pretty smooth texture with that. But I would advise doing it with the brush the first time. If you see anything, oh, there's a globule, you know, it shouldn't have been that big. Sometimes those will show. If you take those off, then basically what you can do is you can give your final coat like that. Also, you can go around with the brush even. Don't do the whole thing worked in. Just do any areas you think are not perfect. And you use this, this little SOS pad, and you go with some soap, Ajax dish soap, and water. Get it to be really smooth. You might have a little bit of areas where you've worked it all the way down and the latex is showing through. Your final coat, just give it a hit with this. Just a hit. Just give it a hit. And before you know it, you are going to be done. One of the areas that I will do more work on is the ears. I will actually go ahead and hit those pretty hard because they're not gonna flex. Why not? Give them some rigidity. Give them a nice coat. Those ears are gonna be pretty good. I mean, you can move them. You can move them if you want to, but they go right back. And if, you know, they're not really gonna move to the point where you can see it unless you actually touch them. Okay, now if you want to, you can take and fill these on the inside so they won't move. But I don't recommend that. You can do it if you want. Also, another thing too, when you're keeping your cowl over a long period of time, I'll take something like this. Piece of tape. Get it right like that, where it's straight up and down. Notice how these ears right now, because the styrofoam head is so small, the cowl wants to go like this. Well, the ears aren't really going like that. It's just that the styrofoam head is so small. If you put it on a good mannequin or you pad this out, then that wouldn't be the case. If you want to store it like that, you can. But if you don't do that and you've got it on a styrofoam head or a smaller head, you want to store it for a period of time. This is what I do if I'm going to store one of these on a styrofoam head for a period of time. I'll go ahead and wrap it in a piece of paper like this, where it's straight up and down like that. I'll push those ears just slightly in, just slightly, and then I'll just tape that. Now it's sitting on the styrofoam head. It wants to go like this because the head's too small inside of it, but it can't. It's forced to stay like that. So depending on your circumstances and how you're storing it, take that into consideration. If it's on your head and you say, I want my ears to look different. If you take and you go and force that inward, okay? Or even this, roll them up really tightly. Lots of things you can do to get your ears to be different. Now, let's see if I did anything here. Just that little bit I did. I don't know if you can see it. Just a little bit I did, even while it's on the styrofoam form, wants this one to go in a little bit while that one's still being pushed out. I would recommend not doing it in a styrofoam form though. Look at yourself first, because if you do it in a styrofoam form and everything's great, by the time you get it on, it could be like this. So basically, you just want to know that this is your friend. This isn't like urethane. It's forgiving. It's got a mind of its own, but it also can be mind controlled, okay? Look at the extra curve I gave to that. I don't want that extra curve. Take a little bit of it out. There, just that little bit. Changed the memory a little bit. Now over time, the memory may change again. You can even heat this up. You can even do additional memory tutorials with your cowl later on. Teach it new tricks. That's what I like about latex. You can teach your old cowl new tricks because it is a totally different animal than those urethane cowls that you see so many places out there. Enough of my love affair with latex. It only goes back 25 years, almost as long as my marriage. So anyway, there we go. So there we have a cowl. And I'm going to do another video on this too, I think. That's just called Real Returns Latex Cowl. Maybe some photographs, maybe not a video, I don't know. But I'll see. And basically that's what it takes to have a cowl that you can call yours, that works right for you. Worth that hour or so of time that you gave it. All right, bad buddies. So for today, that's all this is. Very simple. Also, if you're trying on a cowl for the first time, one of my bad buddies reminded me just the other day, one of the pieces of advice that I used to give, and I know there's new people all the time, one of the reasons I won't let go of a cowl that still has a face in it is somebody might forget to take it out and put it on. If you're a little heavier and you don't use KY, you have trouble getting through the neck, well, make sure everything's just the way it needs to be. And take that final breath, looking through there, making sure you can still breathe, and then just finally just put that last part through. All right, that's the safe way to do it. Very important to do it that way, so you don't get stuck in the neck and have a hard time breathing. And again, if your neck, you want it bigger to get on and off, look like you got some muscles underneath that cowl, do some stretching before you Plastidip it. All right, I like my cowl to be attached to the cape, ideally. And I've noticed that when it does get attached to the cape, every one of these scalps wants to pull. And I don't stretch my neck out because I know that if I'm going to put it on a cape, it's going to want to pull a little bit, just a little bit. And that's going to make the neck stretch out. So I want to start with the neck pretty close to where it's supposed to be, knowing it's going to automatically stretch out a little bit. But one thing also, you know, having it on and just having it loose, hey, just enjoy your costuming. Your general public doesn't know that the returns was attached to the cape. As long as you got somebody with you and you make sure you're straight for photographs and things like that, maybe you don't even want to attach it to the cape. Maybe you just want to have it loose. You want to have a little bit bigger neck to get in and out of it, to make it look like you're a little more, you know, built, then stretch the neck. That's about it, bat buddies. Now that you know what there is to know about a cowl and finishing a cowl, go have at it. Go have some great costuming experiences. Send some photographs. Tell me about your stories. Share on the boards. The new people coming along, they're telling everything for the first time. You've been there many times. You've done that. I think it's great that there's this camaraderie where you take the time to say, yeah, that's great, and talk about the person's suit and everything, even though you've seen thousands of them. Hey, for them, it's the first time. They're having the time of their life. It's great to see you guys all out there supporting them, even though you're as old as me and you've been around this hobby for 25 years. Great to see it, guys. That's it for today. To the bat poles.